my stamp room. Whether you're watching this on the replay or you're here live and getting ready to get going, let's get started.
Stamper, come.
What a morning this has been. Well, hey, I'm serious. I've been so excited to hang out with you today. You know, hey, that's pretty much it. You know, my life, you are the reason I get dressed. And I went all out for polka dots today. Oh my goodness, I knew I missed, I moved that camera. Hold on 1 second. Yeah. See right there? There's a secret. That's the other camera right there. And so we got to get, yeah. That's close enough. And look at, I'm a little bit too low. Yeah, hey. So, hey, we run a professional thing here. And I'd like to welcome all of you. I'm just so excited that you're here. I can't even talk. Oh, and for those of you who like to take a drink when I do, hey, let's start early. Oh, see, yeah, Terry's got that right. You know, there are only good days and better days. Good days are when you wake up breathing. And that has been my motto for many, many, many years. Like longer than I've been married, probably. So who's in first today? You know, we always like to honor the person who comes in first. And it is Diane. It is not the dog. He is not here. I want to know what your dog is doing today. Oh, I'm just so happy. Here's the fun part. Have you ever seen those movies where, you know, somebody laughs so hard they're taking a cup of drink of coffee and they go, welcome to my world today. But it wasn't laughter. I was over here. I wanted to decorate an envelope and I came in here. I took a sip of coffee, and I know this is why they tell you do not go and have liquids around your computer. Something hit the back of my neck. Has never happened. I hope it never happens again. And I just went, whew. The lens here, you know, if I'm a little foggy, maybe the coffee will make me look better. It was on my monitor. I'm sure there's some down in the buttons. I mean, oh my goodness, it's a good thing I wasn't working on a laptop. Hey, look it. Hey, well, you know, she's not brand new, but she's new. Welcome. So, oh, June's here. Oh, we got a lot of you. You know what? The thing about calling everyone out, I'd love to call everybody out, but we would be sitting here for hours and then everybody go, when's she going to get around to my name? So let's go, and we're going to, if you were here early on the Facebook side, you know that I found my dies from yesterday. You know, right now, as a demonstrator, now, you know, as a stamper, it really doesn't matter, but as a demonstrator, I try to keep things, you know, kind of segmented, and it's really kind of hard when we're going out of a catalog and into a new one, because I've had the stars dies in, you know, in with my stuff that is in the January to June mini catalog. But what happens, I went and I put the ones that were carrying over in a special place, the ones that don't fit. This isn't the one. Hold on 1 second. You know, we talked about this one yesterday, right? Hold on. And the ones that don't fit in here, you know, like this, right? Yeah, like that. you know, I rubber band them together. But on the stars, the star dies are continuing on, but the stamp set is not. So what do you do? You know, this in this pile, that's in that pile, and it was only 2 feet away from me. So as soon as we go a little bit through this what did I pick out? 1998. This is the year before I started. Oh, this should be very interesting. It's going to be very bold. I will warn you now. So, you know, I know that I was talking on the phone with Kay yesterday for a little while afterwards. She's down there in Houston, Texas, and the phone cut off. And, you know, this here's something. If you learn nothing else today, here's a non-stamping related tip that might help you. But did you know that when the your cell phone cuts off and you know, because I tried to call her back. I waited an hour and then I tried to call her back, but it still wasn't available. But I could text her because the way that cell towers work and all that stuff, sometimes you can't get out with a phone call, but you can get out with a text. So there you go. So if you still have one of those flip phones, it's time to trade up. So, hey, yes. So, here, if you have never been to our, oh, wow, look at this. I'll show you the beginning of this, but while if you've never been to one of our Throwback Thursdays, everything's different. One thing good about working for yourself, you can do whatever you think everybody wants. And I don't think you want the exact same thing all the time. However, every now and then on Thursdays, we've been having a good time going through some of the old catalogs and seeing how much style changes. Because, you know, when you, we start buying things and then we get in these ruts and we start, well, it's not really a rut, but it can be a creative rut. Maybe you don't, you know, you find yourself using the same stuff all the time, but it's not giving you the same pleasure. That's because, well, it could be because styles change. You know, like those of us who wore hot pants in the 70s, we're not wearing them now. And while other people might be wearing them who have less digits than we do, they don't call them hot pants anymore, do they? Oh, golly. Oh, my goodness. Here's a moment of truth from Kathy. You know, my husband would too, but once I got him a smartphone, the dog makes sure that Anne gets the first smartphone, and then my husband has the old one, and the old one is not very old. I would not want him to have something that was not nice. And so, and in fact, the last one that I had a glitter holder on it, and believe me, we Stamper bought him a new holder because, you know, he is his favorite human. And look who showed up for work. He's like, oh, yep, there. You know what? As soon as the camera goes on him there, he wants to go and do that. You know, just gotta love him. So anyway, here is the catalog from 1997, 1998. And this was the year before I started. And let me get that out of there. And I want you to go and give me some page numbers. And that's where we're going. Now, I'm going to tell you, oh my goodness, they use this for quilting. They use that for quilting. We used to sell them. So back then, we had our own, even more of our own scrapbooks. Because remember, I started, and some of our stuff was not branded like it is. But here, let me show you how this started. I autographed it. Now, welcome to those of you on YouTube and on Facebook. But look here. Okay, here's, you know, come on. I'm glad I wouldn't have to do this. I'm going to have to back this out a little bit. You might see a little bit too much, but boy, I just don't. I have to save up for a new, for a new light. And they run me about $70. So, yeah, you can see why Anne's not buying a new light today. Because Anne just got a new camera. Okay, this should help a little bit. Whoa, that makes me look kind of spooky. Yeah, but it's not all about me. This light source does not really give good light like this one over here that costs more. Let me get out of here because, boy, don't I look spooky? Yeah, that's really weird. even then, it just doesn't look real bright. And here's the thing. I don't like to go and put holes in the wall. But I wanted to show you this because look at, they had a sheet of printed vellum in the front. So we got our first five numbers. And here, now some of you might not know, but that our company was co-founded by two sisters back in 1988. So at this point, the company is 10 years old. And I do know, I'm pretty sure that their convention was in San Diego, because the first Stampin' Up! Demonstrator I met had won or earned, I'm not sure, a free set of markers, and she brought them. And so Shelley just recently on her blog showed a picture of her sister Vonna, and her name's LaVon, right? But she referred to her as Vonna on the thing, because remember, this is the year before I started, because the year I started it was just Shelley. And Polly, here's Shelley's family. So oh my goodness. The person here, I have to make this really close now. See this right there? She's our CEO now. How about that? Boy, I look like I'm on a Halloween gig. Woo! So, wow, okay. Yeah, I have because I used to quilt before I was a demonstrator. In fact, I gave up quilting to do this, to be more active in this. And yeah, so there you go. That's an old picture from, and boy, I wonder if she'd give me, you know, she knows that picture's out there. I once asked in a thing, I once asked Sarah, what did she do in the company, you know, the family business when she was a kid. And you know, we have what we hold our embossing powders in now. Here, let me show you what we do our embossing powders in now. We used to do like eyelets, and she would have, they would have a thimble, and she would have to go and scoop them up and put them in there. Because, you know, I was a kid from a family business, and I, in the fourth grade, I learned how to type, and I went and typed invoices for my parents. Now, they probably threw away a lot. It was a trucking business. They weren't going to give me a truck at 10, you know. So, yeah, doesn't my light... Yeah, well, I wanted to move it so that you could see this better. That's why. That's why it looks so spooky. So, the first thing is, but anyway, that's why I asked her that question, because, you know, when you're in a family business, everybody does a little something, even if it's just taking out the garbage. So, 54, I told you things would be very bold back then, and that was the style. And this was a very popular set, because all you had to do most times is go and cut a piece of paper that, you know, to fit that and stamp it on there, you know. And that's what's good about the things just like this, you know. This is great because it takes up a lot and you could put it on designer series paper. But here, I'm going to tell you what they did on this one right here, is they went and stamped with Versamark, and then they went over it with chalks. We had chalks back then. But back to this. Here you go. I didn't have this one. I know I had this one. So next up is page 66. 66. Oh. Now, I have to tell you that when I used to have a fair amount of alphabets that I never mounted. And look at, aren't those cute, cutesy? You know, I mean, they were in for the time. And look at, you could get these squares, which you would have to cut around them. And yeah, I'm trying to remember if I had, I'm pretty sure I had this one. So next up we have 81. So whether you're new or whether you're not so new, you know, just throw a number out there and we'll see if we can get to it today. Because, you know, I told you 2 days ago, was it, that it was going to be a 100, and it hit 100. Yesterday they said 102, and it hit 102. Today 106, and then tomorrow in the 90s. I think I had this. Oh, let's hide that math. Ooh, can't have math. And this, yeah, this was a doily just cut in half. You know, we've got different doilies all the time. So what have you used over the years? You know, I never got this, but that looks kind of cool. That looks, you know, I love those hats. I mean, wow. Pretty, pretty fancy. 81. Who's 97's next? This was a very popular set back then too. This was two, but I didn't have it. and it went with, oh golly. Now back in the day, let's see, this is page 97. And back in the day, okay, this was before they put the things in the in an index in the back. Let's see, 1 second. Fabulous Flourishes. That's, well, wow, they've used that name more than once. Fabulous Flourishes. Boy, these glasses have coffee on them. Oh, look at, we've got several of you up here, you know, with, you know, I still have my chalks. And and Lisa, she had that quilted alphabet. Yeah, see, and I still have my chalks. I don't use them because I love the blends, you know, and a totally different thing. Oh golly. Oh, I don't know about you, but this is the way I clean my glasses. In a pinch. Anyway, but this, you could use it for summer, for winter. See, here's a more of a springy type. But I'm wondering, what's the name of this greeting? Because I kept that greeting set for a long, long time. It's like basic sayings, basic. But you know, we have double entendres, and if you're wondering what a double entendre is, it's when you have like fabulous flourishes, two words with the same letter. So we got 97, 34 is up next for Diane. I know, maybe we'll come across that. That was a pretty, this is not what, this is 50, 51. This was popular. I'm pretty sure I had that. Where am I going? 34. Oh! I didn't have this one, but I had a different, an older version, a newer version of this one. Oh, golly, Nita wants a smart flip phone. I know I had this. I know I had this wheel. I've kept my wheels. I'm pretty much sure that I'm going to be selling them in one of our sales coming up. If you're new, we do a used stamp sale on the first Friday of every month. Well, almost every month, because sometimes we have to move it to the second Friday. Let's see, 34, 102. Yeah, so what, let me go, now I can go and skip some of this. What? Oh, look at, Anita said that somebody just gave her that that teacup set. And you know, we've got a teacup set now, and it is going away. Yeah. Oh, golly. Yeah. You know, I had to have her, because I did something with a Raggedy Ann. But of course, they can't call it Raggedy Ann. It's Raggedy Angel. But yeah, she looks a little bit, okay, let's kind of check her out a little bit closer here. She looks like she's been taking something small. Yeah, so, you know, Yeah, bold lines are not my style. Well, you know what? Bold lines are not the style right now. They just aren't. But we used to have something, and I think I kept the parts to it. I'm trying to think. See, look at these. These are bold, but they're, you know, they're very, yeah. Hey, let's go look at some accessories. What do you think about that? Because some of this, you know. Oh, I think she's talking about that crazy looking raggedy angel. My hair looks like this unless I use a curling iron. Only it's straight. Yeah, I never got her. Nellie the Nest Lady, but she was very popular. So yeah, you know, you can see how things change. Yes, Elaine, I get you. I so get you. Now this, this was nice. Right here, look at this. There's some bold things that are really very effective. And I'm going to tell you the story about this one. When I was just starting out, I went down to do a party about 40 minutes from my house. And I went to make a card with this stamp set, and I didn't have any purple stamps. So we went and, you know, I don't even know if I bought the green ones for it. So I think we did more mustard. grapes. And this is one of my keepers that I will always keep, the pansy set. This I love this. This two-step stamping, isn't that nice? And this was, you know, we're coming out with a new detailed sunflower set, and this is what it was like. Golly, that's 22 years ago. So look at how much. Oh, see, look at. There's some things that you just get emotionally attached to, and this I like, this I love, and look at the difference between the teapot that is being retired this year and this teapot. Now, this is something, I guess they're not going to carry these anymore because everybody's reading Kindles, right? Hold on, I'm going to look real quick and then we'll get to finishing that card. Yeah, now we have the Tua Wild Rose. This is what they did 22 years ago. But if you go to the home office, they have rooms, not like exactly like this, but where they've stamped on the walls and they've decorated them. See, there's that greeting set I told you. Some greeting sets, oh, look at. Yeah, and we have a cow that's retiring this year. Looks nothing like that. So there you go. I mean, this is just a way that things change over the years. But, oh yeah, let's look at those accessories. Does that remind you of some, you know, butterflies? I mean, oh, look at this card. You could do that so quickly with, and see, they even shadowed it. It's like, yeah. I like to look at things sometimes and just to see. Here, this is the thing that I kept that I probably, you could go and cut this part out in the center and then put it on the front of a card and have like netting in there, and then you could put some potpourri in it. Yeah, I still have that stamp. Ha, look at, now we have the dressed up stuff, and it's way cooler than that. That's okay. You know, I mean, just remember. Oh, yeah, okay, you can have some fun with that. I still have that. Best wishes. Yeah. Is that, what is that stamp set? Hold on. You know what? Now you're going to make me look it up. So, yep. They do make their, you know, everything. they improve the catalogs year by year. And some catalogs, you know, you'll find them that they work better for you, you know. Look how tall and thin. We don't have too many things tall and thin like that. I'm looking for... Is there great textures? Yeah, okay, that's background stamps. Say it with stamps. Okay, it should be in this section. Should be in this section. There you go. Bold and basic greetings. Didn't I say it said basic in there somewhere? So, yeah. And look at that. I mean, that's... But even now... I'd still rather use the ones we have now because but this one lasted a long time because it was just, yeah, so usable. So let's take a quick look at the, oh my goodness, look at all those wheels, all countrified. Whoa, look, yeah, this has been around a while. See, and the markers have not gone up that much. The hard thing is the case, but now we've got storage you can get. Look at, we had scroll and calligraphy pens. Let's see, we saw that. The little corner rounder punches, we still have that, but not quite as much. I do so like our designer series paper. That coordinates with our, you know, just the basic ones. Because this, you buy one print in several colors. And I like that they've evolved. Yes, and that brings me to, if you are thinking that you want to get on the sweet treat train, that's where I send out samples of everything, almost everything new in the new catalog. Go to today's blog post on stamperdog.com and go to today's blog post. I'm looking for, I don't even think I have anything that just says the website, but you know, I mean, it says Stamper Dog everywhere, right? But if you go to today's blog post, and today is the 28th of May, you'll see a list of everything that's included in the packages. I only have, I think, 4 packages before it left before I cut it off. Ah, here's something I haven't seen in a while. Hold on, let's see, where is it? Mulberry paper. You would take like an aqua painter and then just draw a wet line and then tear it. The color cardstock that they had, show us the color cardstock that they had. They had many of the same ones. I'll go back to that. Look at this. Make this a little bit bigger. There you go. All these boxes, storage boxes, a hinge storage box. That would help. I could use some of the, well, I have some of these, and they're down in the bottom, and then I never go and look them up because I have lots of live things. Now, this would not hold punches like that one that I showed you on the organizing session we had on Tuesday. So right now we're doing Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Wow. That's all the embossing powders. Right there. That's all the embossing powders, right? Right here. And then we had, look at all different colors of glitter. I am so surprised they took our glitter away. Our Dazzling Diamonds has got to be the best glitter ever. The best glitter ever, yeah. And this, we even had things to where you could stamp on canvas. Oh, yeah, look at this. I remember these. Very slow drying because they're pigment inks. Same thing with the paint box, color box, all these. And this is what our tool used to look like. And yes, that little thing right here, yeah, burned me on national television. So let's get back. You wanted to see the colors, the colors. This is 1998. Let me go back. Hold on. Oh, you used to be, well, yeah, this, This goes to show you, here's another thing that we used to do. Right here it says rubber mounted. They would sell you rubber mounted stamps that was just the rubber, and then you could go and mount them however you wanted to. I tried that. You could actually, it's not that. I believe it was that you could go and stamp just with that, but you have to be very careful because you get your fingers in the ink, and it was it was just kind of crazy. But look at it, was only $17.50 for that great big stamp set that has 17 stamps in it. But Dreams, it's $24.95, and you had to mount your own stamps back then. So back to the colors. Let's see. And we did personalized name stamps that I liked. The only problem was they smelled really funky. Okay, now it's the wheel. So where are the colors? Colors. Should be next. Yeah, you don't really see the colors so much here. Oh golly, here's somebody's phone number. Okay. Oh, the Victorian house set, okay. So here's colors that aren't here anymore. Not Quite Navy, Eggplant Envy, Forest Foliage, Broke Burgundy, Bordering Blue, Rose Red, Brocade Blue, Rose Romance, Ballet Blue, Marvelous Magenta, and Take It With Teal. All those are gone now. Because remember, it's been 22 years. Things change. Glorious Green is gone. We've had colors similar to them, but not quite. Green Galore, Gable Green, Yo-Yo Yellow, Only Orange, Rocket Red, Pink Passion, Positively Pink, Orchid Opulence, Lovely Lilac, you heard me say that this week, and Brilliant Blue, you heard me say that this week, and Tempting Trick, all of these are gone, but they didn't go all at one time. I think the first time that we really did a big color revamp was 2010. We did one before that where we dropped Rocket Red, Yo-Yo Yellow. But you know what? I never bought, I would go buy a assorted pack anytime I needed only orange or Yo-Yo Yellow, okay? Now, let's go down here. Mellow Moss, I used to have my front room painted that color. All of these are gone. All of those are gone. But it's been 22 years. See, now Lisa said she likes Gable Green, which is this one right there, Brocade Blue. I could never get anything to quite match that. That's over here. And Pretty in Pink. Yes, Pretty in Pink was a very nice pink. Now, Chocolate Chip. Yeah, I can remember the day the Chocolate Chip died in 2010 and close to Coco. And all of these are gone, except for Garden Green. Garden Green is in here, and it's over there, too. Wow. And Basic Black. Because even going, I'd like to know who this is. Huh. It's a Stampin' Up thing. So, yeah, so there you go. We went a lot through this one. So let's show a little bit about that card yesterday. Now, you remember when I went and I colored this yesterday, and I cut it out with the biggest star. And you know what I didn't do is I didn't go and cut the mortarboard or the hat, right? Oh, hey, you know what? I have some of these on Stampin' Spots too, and I was wondering I might go and sell them in the sale. I'm not a big fan of Stampin' Spots. Here, this one is Bermuda Bay. That's a current color, but But it's, you know, you like what you like what I like. You know, and that's okay. Only two colors out of, well, hold on, let me look at it. I'm going to look at it real close because there, in case there was one in that first line. Okay, Ann, really quick. Thank you for hanging in there with me, you know, yeah. Chocolate Chip, but when Chocolate Chip went away, actually Close to Coco went away before Chocolate Chip did, and that's when Early Espresso showed up. Okay, so out of these, there were three, Night of Navy, Garden Green, and Basic Black. That's it. Three. Boom, done. So here we go. I was looking for this. I could not find it. Now I'm going to show you what I did to make this happen, right? Do you think I'm going to, finish this today? I'm not sure. Yes. Now that you're right about that, Marcy. Spots are good for the Stamparatus, and they're great for traveling. And that's what's good about the paper pumpkin kits, because you can just put everything in that little box and take it somewhere, and you've got everything together. So I took the stamp set I showed you yesterday, which is this one, Family Party, right? And this is carrying over, but look at, you have a lot of options with this. And so I went and I had cut these out, if you weren't here, I had cut these out, and then I just cut a strip, and this is 1.5 inches wide this way, and then it's and then I use the, could I have put that away? And then I just laid these on here. So I laid this on, and then I did the two, and then I laid this on here, afterwards. But then I'm going to tell you, I cut this in, and I used the triple banner punch so I could put that notch in there. And then over here, I'm going to tell you what I did. Yeah, that was if I put my scissors where, I'm still getting used to this new system. Oh, come on. Yeah, remember I had coffee. Oh, there it is. Woo, there you go. So then I took this, right? And I kind of gauged where the middle was, and I just put a little puncture right there, and then I cut, because this was a really long piece, and then I just cut it down until I could go and cut that and get away from the hole that I punched. So yeah, that's how I did that, rather than go, okay, I'm gonna pre-cut that. So what I want to do, and yes, I did get the stuff on my I got the coffee on my cardstock and monitor and everything. It was great. So I'm thinking I need a blue backdrop, don't you? I mean, it's just a little bit too much there. Well, let me go pull this over a bit. Don't you just love this? And this special PDF is only going to be available till the second of June. I'm going to make this easy. Now what should I put in the background? Not sure. See here, and yeah, there was my first attempt here. See, and I think because this is so long, I could make it shorter, right? But if I put this on here like this, this is 4 inches by 5.25. And I'm going to go and do some dimensional, or not dimensional, but put some dimension on this with an embossing folder, something that's not too, if I had one with stars, I'd use that, right? Her hat is going to be blue or black, and it's going to be in a small square the size of a mortarboard, because it's a graduation cap. And then, do you think I should probably use the white glimmer, or should I use silver? I don't know whether gold, to put another star behind here. And then, I mean, I could put it on blue, but I was thinking white. So make your vote. Let me know what are you thinking. Now, I do want you to be aware that when you... Oh, this is... I don't want to... I put my, normally I put my glimmer paper in a separate, folder with my neutrals, because I don't want to accidentally pick it up in the dark. And yeah, but it's always a good idea to go and use the thick white, right? You'll notice I have dots here. And if that said cut, that just would remind me to go and move this up here, which I have not changed my blades yet. So I have to remember to do that. So I like to put dots there so that I know it. I don't have to think about it. White glimmer. Okay, that's what I was thinking. The school colors are blue and yellow. And that's why I picked that instead of crushed curry, because crushed curry is more of a gold. But when you use the thick, you know, when you're using the thick for a base, it's always best to go and score it. And then when you score it, you want to turn to the mountainside, right? This doesn't seem... That's sparkly white, shimmer white. I am not going to use that. I'm sorry. I'm going to go get me another. See, I told you what I do, and I must have been in a hurry and just dropped something in there. But I went, oh, well, you know, I thought it kind of felt. And here I had two pieces of thick whisper white right underneath it. Oh. People, I'm just going to tell you, I am here to make all the mistakes on your behalf so that you don't have to. Oh, see, look at now it's a little bit too far that way. It needs to go this way. Yeah, that's what happens when you spill coffee on your monitor. Yeah, everything gets moved. So, yeah, I have not, this is pineapple punch, yep. And that, you know, that just doesn't mean that, and look at this, that is very vanilla. Oh, golly, and Clemmer. I mean, I'm going to trade me in on a new model. You know what? It's always safest in the dark to go grab another piece and cut it, because it only takes just a second and all your friends are patient, right? Yeah, because you're like going, oh, honey, I could have had this whole card done by now. Ah. And the glimmer paper, hold on. Yeah. Let me grab it. Talk amongst yourselves. I'll be back in a second. I'm here. I'm only like three feet away. Oh. Now, I don't know how many of these are sold out, because they are changing them. And I hate to tell you that some of the stamp sets are now no longer available, because I tried to warn everyone last week that they were going to quit making stamp sets. And I looked last night, and yes, they have. Yeah, that's white. Okay. Now, you don't have to watch me score this again. Anyway, the reason why you want to score this when it's thick is because you're going against the grain. And while the thin might not warble when you fold it, it's these are much more sturdy. This is great. Nita says she needs something like that. So here, I'm just putting this on here so you can see. I just put it with a quarter, and if I put this here, and then, hold on 1 second. Here's the silver, right? And this is going to have texture. Personally, I would have liked crushed curry with it. So if their colors are gold, then crushed curry makes a really nice golden blue. And this is a blueberry bushel that is being retired. Oh, golly, you guys just never cease to make me feel good. Yeah, I don't think the gold goes with it. But the shimmery white, oh, boy. Sparkle glimmer paper. Yeah, this one's not even open. I'm still going to open it because if I need it, I need it. Well, maybe it'll be faster if I don't. But, oh, see, look at that. Gives it like more of a hologram effect. Yeah. Because personally, I think it's got too much yellow on here. Well, of course, we have to remember I'm not really... And then, you know, something like the Subtles embossing folder or that new Tasteful Texture one that's coming out next week. Yeah. So if you are a current customer of mine, yeah, you're going to be getting something today or tomorrow to invite you to a private Facebook group. Yeah. Hey. Yeah. Something where it's just going to be for my clients who shop with me in my online store and those, you know, like in my stamp club and, in the Stampin' Pop Club. And I'm, you know, eventually when things start normalizing back to a new way of doing things, I'll be going on live here maybe once a week and in there once or twice a week. Or I really haven't kind of figured it out because it just takes a while for my brain to like, woo, you know, kind of work. And we would love to have you in there. So if you haven't shopped with us, hey, now would be a good time to do it. Because, you know, all my shoppers online, since they don't get to, like, see me one-on-one, you know, and, well, nobody touches each other now, right? It's like, tap. Oh, yeah. Anyway. Yeah, now would be a good time, and check out the retiring list because it's getting less and less and less and less. And you know what? I'm cleaning out stuff. I'm going to give away a prize because you guys have hung around this long, you know, and I'm sure if you haven't already, you know, you might want to like and subscribe because that's really what kind of, you know, lets me know you're here even if you didn't have a chance to participate, you know, and say something. Because, like, you know, sometimes people have problems with their phones, or like when I watch on TV, I don't have a keyboard to the TV. Oh, yeah, subtle bling. Yeah, you know, yeah, I don't know. Okay, so before I go and do that, which one should I do? The silver, or should I do, because I think the gold's a little bit too much. I don't know. I think, well, here I am showing you, and you're not looking. See, there's the silver, and there's the white. I really like this stuff. Ask Kay. Kay knows everything about the catalog, more so than I do. But, yeah, let me go and see how many people we have in here. I've got some cool stuff out there. We got 100, and I have to do math. 181. But you got to be here. Yeah, you know how that works. 158. So here, I'm going to show you this while you, so you can tell me what, you know, what do you think we should do? Silver or white? Now I have to, now you're going to make me work here. And here we have
winner
Susan John. Let's see what you guys are saying. Elaine's like, I'm here. Okay, so we've got 2 white and 2 silver, 3 silver, 3 white, 4 silver. Oh, that is funny. Yeah, I don't think I ever got that one, Anita. Yep. I know Susan's here because 53 seconds ago she said this. So I know she's here. Yeah, so there you go. I am so glad and so happy that you hung out with me during this time when I look like a ghost. Whoa. Oh, yes. Make sure you come back. We're going to be here Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. And if you are one of my shoppers, yay, make sure you look for that invitation to join our private Facebook group, because it is going to be fun. And we're going to put Susan and Kay in charge of everything. Oh, golly. Now all I have to do is drop this thing. This is great. Hey, this is Ann and Stamper from stamperdog.com, where we try to put a little ink, paper, and fun
yes
into your day.